Hare Krishna. When the sensual deludes the eye, the spiritual eludes the eye. The eye can refer to the eyes with which we see. The eye can also refer to the self. So when the sensual deludes the eye, that means that when our eyes get caught with sensual pleasures, and why do they delude us? Because often sensual things look irresistibly attractive. They look incredibly pleasurable. And we get captivated, so captivated that often we just can't think of anything else. We think of gaining such sensual pleasures more and more and more and more. And thus, we stay caught, we stay captivated. And when we are deluded like this, with our minds and minds filled with fantasies of how we will enjoy in the future, constantly looking for such pleasures, then we can't even think of anything higher. The spiritual eludes the eye. The eye, the self, cannot perceive anything spiritual. Because even if there is something higher, we immediately are dragged down to lower pleasures. And we just feel, this is what I want. This is so enjoyable. And this is so easily available. Why perceive anything higher in life? So the steady focus needed for pursuing spiritual reality is just not there. In the 15th chapter of the Bhagavad-Gītā, Krishna points to this when he says, Yatanto yoginaschainam pashyantyatmanyavasthitam yatanto apyakritātmano nainam pashyantyachetasaha. That yatanto yoginaschainam, that the yogi endeavors, pashyantyatmanyavasthitam, and the yogi sees by the self, pashyantyatmanyavasthitam. Yatanto apyakritātmano, akritātmano. But somebody who doesn't see spiritually, what happens to them? Somebody who is actually not endeavored to situate themselves on the spiritual platform, they are caught and captivated by the endless waves of sensual desires that come into their consciousness, then they cannot experience spirituality. Nainam pashyanti achetasaha. They are misdirected, and because of their misdirected consciousness, they cannot perceive higher reality. That's why it's important for us to restrain ourselves sensually if we want to pursue spirituality. Of course, it doesn't that one has to stop for the other. We can keep pursuing spirituality as much as we want, but spiritual truths will be difficult for us to comprehend them, to connect with them, if we are too sensually captivated. So with whatever regulation we have, we try to connect with spirituality, try to understand spirituality as much as we can. And even if we don't understand, we don't demand understanding immediately, but rather we keep pursuing the spiritual path, and gradually as we get a spiritual connection, we get spiritual satisfaction, then the sensual delusion decreases, and then spiritual comprehension will come. Then the self will no longer elude the eye, but rather the self will realize that the eye will realize the self. We will understand ourselves as souls and delight in our spirituality. Thank you. Hare Krishna.